SMS, social distance, mask and sanitizer. Please frequently and thoroughly wash your hands for every 2 to 3 hours with the soap or sanitizer. Right? When you are going out, please wear your mask and go and maintain the social distance. Now, coming to the class, in the last class we have discussed about the third lesson, part A, that is about the landforms, and in the third B we have discussed about the Appanavapuram village in the Krishna Delta. What is the delta here? The water which is going to flow into the sea, that is Bay of Bengal, that water is diverted to the other parts of the places. Right? I hope we already have gone through the textbook and we have did the third textbook reading. Now, in this class, we are going to discuss about the next topics related to the third lesson, part B. Before going to that, where is the Bandar Canal? Bandar Canal. It is in the Krishna Delta near Uyur town, away from the 3 kilometers. And what are the soils are there in the Bandar Canal? The important 3 soils are there, that is alluvial soil. What is the other name of alluvial soil? Alluvial soil is Onru Bhumi. Right? And the second soil is clayey black soil. And here also alluvial black soil. And clayey black soil is known as Nallaragidi Bhumi. Right? Nallaragidi Bhumi. And the third one is sandy soil. Is Isuka Bhumi. Now here the fertile land, the land, the water which is coming from the high level lands, example from the hills, that water will carry the outer layer of the hills, that is the alluvial soil which contains a more amount of nutritious values in it. So the clayey soil is the black soil which contains, which have the capacity of holding the large amount of water for the longer time. Well, this land is also helpful to pluck very easily whenever we are growing the new plants. Now moving to the sand soil or sandy soil, is known as the Isuka Bhumi, and mostly here very near to the canals we can observe this soil. So all the 3 types of soils are there in the Appanavapuram village, and with the help of this soil we can able to grow different types of crops. With the help of those crops, where the farmer can be able to provide the food for everyone. Right? Now, move to the next one, that is about the rainfall. Now, for growing the plants, we require the more amount of water. Few plants are there which require the less amount of water also. Wherever we have the Bandar Canal. Now, in this area, the Bandar Canal is there. The places which are very near to the Bandar Canal, the people will fetch the water from the Bandar Canal and supply the water to the fields. Where there is no need to work hard for supply of water. They usually need to divert the water also to the plants. The plants will cultivate very easily. Now in the same way, the people who are living far away from the Bandar Canal, they have to dig the tube wells. Right? Now the help of the tube wells, they will supply some water to all the plants. The people who are very near to the canal, they will fetch the water or they will divert the water to the agricultural field where there will be a good supply of water to the plants. Now in the same way, the people who are living away from the canal, they have to dig the bore wells. With the help of that, they supply the water to all the plants. Regarding this, all things we have discussed in the previous section. Now in this session, we will read about the other topics, that is about the crops. What are the crops? The food we eat in our daily life, those all we are getting from the crops. Even in the crops also we have the 2 types of crops. 2-3 types of crops. This topic is not there in your book, but in the higher classes you will read. And already you have done about these topics in your primary classes also. 3 types of crops. That is a kharif crop, a Rabi crop and Zaid crop. Kharif crop is also known as a monsoon crop. During the rainy season we'll grow these plants or crops. And the Rabi crops are winter crops. The crops which require the less amount of water and which do not require the more amount of water, the plants mostly will grow in the Rabi season. Those are winter crops. And the plants which doesn't require any supply of water, example mostly for the vegetables, like for the crops we call as Zaid crops, and it is in the not summer season also, either monsoon or winter season, the leftover season. The summer or spring. Right? Now here, what are the crops are grown in the Panamakuru village? You can see here. Now, I request everyone to be read the page number 21. Now, crops. Paddy is extensively cultivated all over the coastal plains, especially in the Krishna district. Most of the lands, especially low areas, are pallam, are sown with the paddy. The area, already in the last class I told what is a coastal area. What is a coastal area? The land and water. Here we have the complete land and here we have the variable sea. So this area will come under the coastal plain. This is a western coastal plain and this is a eastern coastal plain. Now in this plain, the areas which are very near to the water, where we have the more amount of water facility, the common lands will come under the pallam. Right? Pallam or lowlands. Now, as these areas have the very good source of water, they will grow the food crop like paddy. Right? Because paddy requires a more amount of water. Now, the nursery for the paddy monsoon crop is called salwa. Is sown and transplanted in the months of June or July. So here the paddy crop, mostly in which season the farmer will grow the paddy, especially in the monsoon season. Monsoon season is nothing but the rainy season. Monsoon or rainy season. In this season, especially the farmer grow the paddy, which requires more amount of water. Right? And this paddy is known, this crop is known as a salwa. The farmer, when he is growing the paddy, especially in the monsoon or rainy season, that we call as a salwa. I hope you understood this. Right? Especially in the months of June or July. They usually grow high yielding paddy varieties like NTU, 2716, Swarna and BPD. What are the high yielding paddy varieties? Now how we have the toothpaste? I am giving an example. How we have the toothpaste like Colgate, Sensodyne, Wade Shakti, Pepsodent, Closer. In the same way here also, for growing the more amount of paddy crop, we have the different varieties, different types of seeds. They are named with NTU. Next 2716, Swarna, BPT. So here these are the varieties of seeds which are helpful for growing the more amount of paddy crop. Now this is harvested around October to November. These all are sown in the month of June or July, and by the month of October or November, these trees are harvested. What is the meaning of harvesting? Taking out all the grown crops from the agricultural field. The main agricultural operations like ploughing, threshing and transportation are done with the tractors. Now here the combined harvester machine will be there, where this machine will perform all the three important activities, that is ploughing the ground, sowing the seeds and threshing. So there are three important activities which are done by the tractor. Now transplantation is still mainly done by women, whereas harvesting is done by men and women together. What is a transplantation? Planting the trees, and it is very easy work. Who will do this? Women will do. And who will do the harvesting work? Well, the farmers will collect the bunch of all the crops in the hand. They will do the harvesting work, right? Who will do this? Men and women both. From the month of December, they sow the winter crop called Tharva. Monsoon crop is known as Salva, and the winter crop is known as Dalva. Monsoon in the month of June or July, right? Now the winter crop is known as Dalva in the month of December. Now this is either paddy or pulse crop. During the last few years, many farmers have been cultivating the sugarcane instead of paddy. Now when we have the good amount of water, the farmer is going with the paddy. When we have the less amount of water, less rainfall, during that period the farmer will opt for the sugarcane, right, which requires a small, very less amount of water. Such crops are grown in the December, and especially in the June or July, paddy, and in the month of December, sugarcane. Now then it grows again to give a second crop next year. These crops need planting throughout by the year, and this is done only by men, but immediately after harvesting work is done. Now whatever the remaining leftover will be there on the land, that all will be burned by the farmers, and they will prepare the land for the next crop, so that in a year the farmer can be able to grow the two types of crops. Nowadays the villages cultivate turmeric, yam, banana, etc. in the uplands. They are sown with the arrival of rains and harvested in February or March. Crops like sugarcane, turmeric, yam and banana are grown for sale in the market and are not consumed in the village. Now the lowlands, example the lands very near to the coastal areas, is known as a pallam. In this pallam, as there is a good source of water, the farmer is going with the paddy. And in the uplands, the areas are away from the water bodies, in such areas the farmer is growing the instead of paddy, they are going with the turmeric, yam, banana, which requires a less amount of water. Now and especially what all the cash crops are there, where by selling them in the market, the farmer can able to make more money. Such crops are not consumed. Not consumed means not taking for their own purpose, but they are selling in the market to make the money. In the olden days, the farmers of Penamakul cultivated wet gram, green gram and millets on the uplands. They did not require much water. Nowadays, these crops have been replaced with the vegetables, sugarcane, which require the irrigation. The crops which doesn't require the more amount of water, that crops are grown especially in the winter season or in the summer season. Example, the vegetables. Right? Now, along with the vegetables, few people are there in the backyard of the kitchen, means backside, most of the villages we can see. Back of the kitchen, the people will be having the very big open place where they can grow the different types of vegetables, flowers, fruits, and the help of that they can able to make the money. In the same way here also, whenever the farmer is not getting sufficient required amount of water, in that place the farmer is going with the fruits or the vegetables where you can able to grow them very easily. Now I hope you have understood till here. Now move to the next one, that is about the vegetables. Let me repeat. The crops which are grown in the lowlands, very near to the coastal areas, is known as the pallam. right? And the crops which are grown in the month of June or July is a monsoon season, is a rainy season for us. That's in the season, mostly the farmers will grow the paddy, that we call as sarva. And the winter season, during the month of December, we'll be coming across with the winter season. In this winter season, the farmers will go with the sugarcane, and not only sugarcane, but also they will grow the turmeric, yam nothing, but it is like a potato, which is brown in color. And that we call as a dalva. Monsoon crops is known as a sarva, and winter crops are known as dalva. I hope you have understood this. Now, moving to the next topic, that is about the vegetables. What are vegetables better nowadays? The cost of vegetables are climbing sky. They are very costly because of heavy rains. Now we'll see here vegetables. Uplands is nothing but meraka or garubhumi. Garubhumi means the land which is not suitable for growing the more amount of crops. Gatti bhumulu will say in Telugu, no? The same way, the gatti bhumulu is nothing but meraka bhumulu or garuva bhumulu. Of this village are suitable for growing vegetables. The uplands, wherever we don't have the very good supply of water, in the places the farmers are growing the vegetables. In the low-lying lands, if water is not sufficient for a second crop of paddy, they cultivate vegetables. If the water is not sufficient for the crops, like the sugarcane, paddy, cotton, jowar, wheat, so in place of these all things, the farmer is growing the vegetables and pulses. Pulses is something but the popular will say in Telugu. The same way, your pulses are required the less amount of water, like vegetables. Now, in the low-lying lands, if water is not sufficient for the second crop of paddy, they cultivate vegetables. Usually, they cultivate brinjal, ladies finger, ivy gourd, yani dodakai, rich gourd and cabbage. They are sold in Viyuru Raitu Bazaar. During summer, some farmers cultivate jurugu or pilli pesara papu, you know, no? That one. To increase the fertility of their fields, there are leguminous green manure crops which fix nitrogen in the soil after 30 to 40 days. These crops are ploughed back into the soil here when there is no sufficient amount of water. The farmer is going with the vegetables and pulses. By growing the pulses, different types of pulses here, the land will acquire the good fertility and it will remain very fertile for the longer time. I hope you have understood till here. Please go with the textbook reading about the crops and vegetables. Normally, what all the eatables are there in our regular life? That all crops will be grown by the farmer during the winter season where he doesn't have the more amount of water. Please copy all today's homework. Read lesson. I hope you have understood this. Please take care.